Hi, I'm Patricia Bleckman. If you're using the KE2 Edge Manager and KE2 wireless sensors, and you've pulled up the dashboard, you probably noticed that the devices are listed by their unique MAC address, which is essentially the sensor's name, which doesn't help you actually know where your sensor is in the facility. Renaming your sensors might not seem like a priority, and if you're only using two or three, you may be right. But with even 5 sensors, it can be a huge time saver later, helping you quickly locate the sensor in the building. To change the sensor's name, you'll need to access your KE2 Edge Manager. First, connect to the same network as the KE2 Edge Manager. Then, enter the HTTP information from the label in your web browser address bar. This brings you to the dashboard. In the upper right of the page is the management button. Click the button and the login prompt will appear. Log in, then go to the first device you want to name. The naming convention that I prefer is to simply identify the location where I'm using the sensor, like left cold rail. And that's it. You now have a meaningful name for the sensor. And if you're using KE2 controllers, you can change their names too by essentially following the exact same process. Also, be sure to keep a physical list, like our sensor identification chart, with the sensor name and location. This information resides on the Edge Manager, so if the device gets damaged, say from a lightning power surge, you won't be stumbling in the dark trying to recreate the information. For more information on the KE2 wireless sensors, please visit our website or contact our sales or technical support teams.